In this chemical evolution, in this theory, they say that the last universal common ancestor, that is LUCA, origin of life from the non-living matter. This is nothing but it is called as abiogenesis. Abiogenesis is nothing but how the life has come into existence from the non-living things. Okay, the first is organic monomers. Prior to the existence of cells, amino acids and nucleotides. So this is the organic monomers. Next is the organic polymers. Monomers which are polymerized to form the DNA, RNA, that is deoxyribonucleic acid and ribonucleic acid, and also the proteins. Next is the protocells, which are nothing but the polymers. So if you see here the different reactions of how LUCA is this. This is the last universal common ancestor that has been existed, and from here how the cell is going to evolve and give rise to the new life. This is nothing but the here. If you see the biological evolution, just now I told you how the cell is giving from the protocell, that is from the plasma membranes, how it is forming the protocells and how the cells are formed. This is the origin of the genetic code, the origin of the genetic code, and also you can see very clearly the formation of endoplasmic reticulum and also the mitochondria. This is called as biological evolution, and this is the chemical evolution. In this chemical evolution, if you look it here, it is very clear that when the earth was formed, the early earth when it was formed, the inorganic chemically formed substances which are there, they capture the energy and they form the small organic molecules. This is called as the stage one. And after this, polymerization process will occur and the polymers are formed, and ultimately they form the protocells and cells are formed. So this is how the origin of life for the LUCA method was postulated. Now coming to the different stages in the origin of life. If you see, these are all the different stages in the origin of life, where the prebiotic chemistry, that is nothing but the chemical evolution which gives rise to the protocells, and the protocells ultimately to the ribosites, wherein the DNA plus RNA plus protein, they form the ancestral cells. So the self-organizing systems here, and also the protobioenergetic mechanism which established in the amphiphilic vessels, and also all are under the autonomous systems, and the hereditary mechanisms based on the pre-RNA templates. So different types of templates have also been come into existence at this particular stage. The biosynthesis of ribonucleotides. So how the different types of bionucleotides, that means how the sugar molecules will be combined with the organic molecules and also with the phosphorus to form the nucleotides and also nucleosides.